snow. I have carved out this soul made of stone, and I will drag.
Hello everyone and welcome to Fury. I'm mtbHKK and we are on our way. It's go home week towards Royal Rumble week. We're kicking things off with the Mixed Martial Arts General. Well, V-Pac, it's going to be an interesting night for you as well, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, you bet it is, MTB. Tonight, I go one-on-one with the Euro-American champion, Malik Brown.
Indeed, this is probably going to be the biggest match of your career, V-Pac.
It most certainly is. I got goosebumps, but boy, have I been looking forward to this. But as soon as I'm done with Malik Brown, I'm coming after Tommy Ventura's demon ass.
That'll certainly be an interesting thing to see.
Well, in any case, that's later tonight. Right now we got George Alpine in the ring, the former TPGW World Champion.
Indeed, it'll be interesting to see how Georgie handles himself here tonight against this man, the higher standard, CJ Hawkins. Whoa! Man, V-Pac, you damn well know that CJ Hawkins is set and ready for the action here tonight.
And he most certainly is. Of course, CJ Hawkins recently made his return to TPGW not too long ago.
Indeed, who can forget the classic match he had with Daniel Stone back at Crossroads? CJ Hawkins coming up short, but him and Alpine both. We'll be in the Royal Rumble match in V-Pac tonight. We're going to find out who the mystery 10th man in the Royal Rumble match is going to be representing TPGW. So far, the only names we know so far are CJ Hawkins, George Alpine, Duncan Vermeil, Rex Titus, Dr. Dream, Raven Dark, and Mal Rian, I believe. There is still one mystery man left.
Well, have to find that out later tonight. I know you should be open for thinking of that. We got our 10 guys.
Indeed, as well as ZCW's 10. I know Zahia is looking forward to that. And here we go with this matchup. CJ Hawkins and George Alpine starting things off. And Hawkins! Impressive Michinoku driver there. Dropping the elbow now, and V-Pac, look at this action.
Yeah, CJ Hawkins quickly going to work here on the former TPGW World Champion. Look at this! Well, Tiger suplex there.
Indeed, well, of course, CJ Hawkins, former face of BYU, and of course, former TPWF World Heavyweight Champion.
That was the promotion that was before TPGW, right?
That's right, it was the preceder. He was CJ Hawkins was actually the man who retired that championship.
And then he went on to bigger, his career, right?
Indeed. He went on to main event events such as Call All-Star 6 against AJ Young. And what a classic battle that was. Whoa!
Right now he's in there with Alpine, who's a former world champion himself.
Indeed, and uh-oh. Look out, here comes Hawkins. Snap suplex! Now Hawkins going for the cover. One, two, and no.
Only a two count there from CJ Hawkins. And you gotta wonder if both of these vets are looking towards Royal Rumble week, MTV.
Indeed. They're gonna be in the Rumble match. And uh-oh, wait. Here comes Alpine GTS.
Well, he's not done.
Off the ropes, penalty kick.
Of course, I know that move as the Burning Rush over at UCWL.
And Alpine going up top.
Alpine, yeah, what's this?
Oh, try for a knee.
You know, like a knee drop off the top rope, but missed.
Indeed, this is going to be an impressive battle. Let's not forget, back in the old TPWF days, there was a triple threat match to decide the number one contender for Raven Dark's world title. It was Hawkins, Alpine, and Matt Farrow. And Hawkins, of course, won that match and went on to win the world title back then. So these two know each other pretty well. And Hawkins!
Off the ring apron, taking down George Alpine.
As a matter of fact, it was during a Royal Rumble week that Hawkins won his world championship. So Hawkins has always had good luck with that particular event.
Hawkins now with Alpine. Alpine counters. And he sends Hawkins back into the ring and hits him in the face with an elbow.
Whoa! Look at this, Hawkins! Oh!
Yeah, that's the athleticism right there, CJ Hawkins.
And Hawkins.
Top row.
Oh! Ooh! Didn't quite get the Phoenix Splash. May have overjudged the distance there.
That deserves a cartoon sound effect. Ah, look at this, though. Hawkins not letting the botch. Phoenix Splash trying to stop him, but Alpine is retaking control of this matchup.
Indeed, and just think of it. All Alpine needs to hit is that knee strike. And this one
That's
could be
right.
over. Although the same can be said for the Hawks wings. Whoa, oh!
Ah, look at that. Hawkins sent to the outside there.
Crashing and burning on the outside of the LED.
Alpine, they'll sit back in.
Uh-oh!
What's this?
Georgie, Anaconda Vice!
We're now slamming the Anaconda Vice shades of a former Straight Edge world champion.
Indeed, this is a George Alpine has used this move in the past. And look at this!
Trying to get CJ Hawkins to tap out, but CJ using his knees to get out of that hold.
Indeed. And whoa! CJ Hawkins, he's a tough man to tap out. And look at these, and look at this.
Alpine, series of clotheslines.
And into the cover, and no. Alpine has been on a little bit of a roll since he defeated Mal Rian in their free fall Hell in a Cell match. Oh!
Chicken wing gutbuster there by Alpine, otherwise known as the Dodon.
I can't remember the last time George Alpine used that move. But nonetheless, look at this reversal. Oh!
Down to the canvas goes Alpine.
And Hawkins may be on his way to taking Alpine down. Off the ropes. Oh!
Nice shining wizard there from CJ Hawkins.
Indeed. Hawkins still in full control. Uh-oh. You think he's going to try for it again, V-Puck?
He might.
Phoenix Splash, and he hits it right on the money this time.
It.
With the cover.
Two. Go.
And Hawkins looks shocked. But that's not the only move in his arsenal. Oh, wait a minute. Alpine, reversal.
Alpine sweeping the legs of CJ Hawkins. They control this matchup.
Look at this. Sit out, Spine Buster. Quickly kicking him off there. And V-Pac Hawkins may be looking to end this one.
Well, he could be, but no, Alpine back to his feet.
Goes back to a knee. Oh, and now dropped right back down his back. Hawkins is in full control right now. Oh, but look at this Alpine reversal.
Alpine able to escape out of that hold. He did the midsection block. Wait a minute.
Oh! Big time power bomb from CJ Hawkins. One, two. And what? Oh no! It is the most overused move in DCA, the powerbomb into the Boston Crab.
The move that was formerly overused in DCA, no, you mean correct, MTB.
That's not what Zahaya told me to say.
Well, Zahaya got yelled at by...
Oh! And there's the Alpine knee strike. Alpine ran up and hit that knee strike right on the money, V-Pac, but it didn't put Hawkins away, but it did bust him open.
And now, CJ Hawkins, what's this?
Whoa! Well, Hawkins was going for some
Yeah, Spybuster there by George Alpine.
And Alpine, I think he's looking for that knee strike again. Oh, he got it! And that may be all she wrote. Alpine with the cover. Two!
And this one's over.
Alpine just defeated CJ Hawkins. What a battle!
Taking a look at some of the action that took place during this matchup.
What a massive victory for George Alpine, and what momentum he'll get from this going into the Rumble match.
Exactly.
Well, nonetheless, congratulations to George Alpine on an impressive victory here tonight, hitting that knee strike one more time and knocking the higher standard clean out. Alpine has never looked more focused than I've seen tonight, V-Pac.
Yeah, you can say that again. In the end, it was In the end, TJ Hawkins may have underestimated George Alpine. Just, as you can see, this crowd is just not, it's not pleased with Alpine at all.
Indeed. George Alpine may have earned this one, but he still hasn't earned the fans' admiration. Especially for being CJ Hawkins tonight.
Exactly.
But still, what a clash.
That's right. Well, and coming up next, we have our second match of the night.
Indeed. We've got ourselves a one-on-one match between two more competitors in the Royal Rumble match. And this match was announced on Showdown, as Dr. Dream will be taking on Raven Dark in his return match tonight.
Oh boy.
Well, nonetheless, it's going to be absolutely impressive to see how Dr. Dream handles himself against the Dark One tonight, V-Pac.
Yeah, it should be interesting.
Dream qualified by winning a six-man battle royal. Uh-oh! The Dark One coming on Fury! And V-Pac, listen to this ovation.
Oh, wow.
Raven Dark, the Dark One, the former world champion, walking down to the ring like something out of an old horror movie.
Well, yeah, I can tell you right now, MTB, I think Dr. Dream may have bitten off more than he could chew.
Indeed, the Dark One is a terrifying individual. Who's ever forget the classic battles Raven Dark has had at Revolution? That a Hell in a Cell match against Duncan Vermeil. And of course his battle for Winter Reign's contract against Soul Reaper.
Well, that's interesting. I didn't know that.
Indeed, the Dark One's made his mark on TPGW or TPWF in the past. And tonight, we're about to see the return of the Dark One to action. And here we go.
Well, MTB, I hate to break this to you, but you're probably going to have to call this one a low because, if you excuse me, I got a match to get ready for.
Indeed you do, V-Pac. Go ahead and go
I'll
get ready.
Well,
as D-Pac goes to get ready for his match with Malik Brown, it's going to be yours truly calling this match as the Dark One goes right to work on Dr. Dream. And oh! What a backdrop right there from the Doc. And look at this, just raking the eyes of the Dark One there. Dream has been absolutely impressive since Elimination Chamber week ended. Dr. Dream seems to have found new life. But nonetheless, the Dark One may be looking to suck the life right out of him. And these fans definitely on the returning Dark One side. Old school TPWF crowd here tonight. Excited for both of these former TPWF champions. One a former world champion, the other a former intercontinental champion, as Dr. Dream hits a knee. And Raven Dark is in trouble. Raven Dark dodging the kick there. Oh, and a backbreaker. Now Raven Dark off the ropes. Oh! Ladies and gentlemen, we may be seeing the resurgence of the Dark One, but Dream is going to be fighting with everything he's got as he hits an arm drag. Now just slamming Raven Dark's head against the mat there. Going up to that second rope. And Dream is going to be looking for something big here. Off the ropes, axe handle! Raven Dark is in trouble. This could be ring rust, ladies and gentlemen. Let's not forget, Dr. Dream's been competing all year, while Raven Dark has been sitting on the sidelines waiting for an opportunity to return. Look at this, Raven. Reversal with a clothesline. Big time clothesline. And the Dark One's in full control. Once again. And Dream may be about to get a very rude awakening. Choke slam! And look at this, Dream trying to crawl back to his feet here. And Raven Dark, he's got him up. How about a little darkness falls power bomb? Good night. With the cover, one, two, no! Kick out at two from Dr. Dream. Again, ring rust. Raven Dark doesn't have the same oomph that he used to have back in the day. I can definitely tell you that he'll be taking the fight to Dream here. Uh-oh. Look at this! Where is Dr. Dream getting this from? If Dream defeats Raven Dark tonight, I am going to be shocked. Uh-oh. Never mind. Choke slam! First you don't succeed, try again, and Raven Dark trying again, but Dream fighting back! Ladies and gentlemen, this is incredible. Dr. Dream is putting up a real fight tonight. Oh, atomic drop! And Dream now, uh-oh, he could be looking for that camel clutch. Dream's got it locked in, is Raven Dark gonna submit? This Dream's got it sitting down on it real tight. This could be it for the Dark One, but no, wait. He fights his way out. Raven Dark now. Oh, another backbreaker. And Raven Dark. He's measuring Dr. Dream. This could be it. Darkness falls. Into the cover. One, two, and that's all she wrote. The Dark One is back. Shaking off the ring rust like it was nothing. Raven Dark 100% impressive tonight. With the deadly precision of a raging mastodon, Raven Dark brought the fight to Dream and hit a second Darkness Falls in this match. Against the game Dr. Dream.
for the 1-2-3 and the victory. Congratulations, Raven Dark, on an impressive victory here tonight. And I'm looking forward to seeing what he does in the Rumble match. The Dark One back in all his glory. But ladies and gentlemen, coming up next is a clash that, well, V-Pac's been waiting for. And I think the entire internet wrestling community's been waiting for as well. As V-Pac will be in action against Malik Brown. Right after this. Well, wait a minute! Titus, he's attacking Malrean. Malrean's supposed to be in the Rumble match. I think Rex is trying to take out his Rumble competitors. Ow! He couldn't go after Raven, so he's going after Malrean. Oh God, Rex has got a chair. Oh! Titus has lost his mind. Ever since Duncan came back, he's been looking for some way to assert his dominance. And on top of that, Raven Dark's back now. Oh God, now Raven in trouble. Oh! Throw kick. Come on, Rex. Don't do this. Don't do this. Oh! No! Oh, God, Rex. Don't do this. No. Oh! God! The television in there just exploded. God in heaven. Oh God. Now what's Rex doing? Rex, you already proved your... Oh no, don't do this. No. Oh! He folded up Mal...
I wanna take
Coming up next, V-Pac is about to have the match of his career against the current Euro-American champion and ZCW Pride champion, Malik Brown. It's going to be one hell of a clash. Next on TPGW Live. Good luck, V-Pac. You're going to need it. Good God Almighty. Well, here he comes. Good luck, man. Is set for action against Malik Brown. Let's not forget this all stemmed from all the crap that Tommy Ventura's been giving him. V-Pac on his way down to the ring, dressed in his all blue armor. I thought Roman Reigns had a lot of armor. All jokes aside, V-Pac, I am looking forward to seeing how you do in this match, my man. But you're going to need it. He's going to need it, folks. Especially considering that his opponent is the mayor of the Violent Party. Championship, and ladies and gentlemen, we haven't heard hide nor hair from Matt Farrow since. It's almost like he's vanished off the face of the earth. He hasn't shown up in TPGW or WFS. So the question is, if Malik Brown did that to Matt Farrow, what is he going to do to V-Pac tonight? Look at Malik Brown just casually strolling down to the ring. But the man in that ring does not matter to him at all. I know with all the stuff that's gone on in DCA, this is a match that V-Pac has been looking forward to without a shadow of a doubt. It's the biggest match in V-Pac's career. But to Malik Brown, it may be just another victim. Well, nonetheless, here we go with this matchup. V-Pac versus Malik Brown. Here we go! And here we go. Malik Brown not starting things off. V-Pac and Malik Brown, I think they're sizing. Whoa! There's a lockup. Look at this, Malik Brown going right behind. And instantly taking V-Pac down. Let's not forget Malik Brown. Oh, God, quick shot right there. Malik Brown a lot more experienced than V-Pac in a wrestling ring. And look at this, Malik Brown now. Off the lockup, going right after... Oh, into the hammerlock. And V-Pac finally reversing. Look at this, into a Fujiwara armbar. Malik Brown flips out of it, though. Oh, and the enziguri instantly. It almost feels like Malik Brown is playing with V-Pac here. Oh! I think he is. And V-Pac not liking that one bit. Oh, but Malik Brown moved out of the way. Good God. You can definitely tell the experience factor from the early goings of this match. Whoa! V-Pac moving out of the way. Oh! Getting off a nice kick there. I'm pretty sure Malik didn't appreciate that. Now off the ropes. Oh, Malik Brown moves out of the way. And Malik now. Oh! The second V-Pac got any offense off, Malik Brown instantly got back into this. And Malik Brown looks like he's taunting V-Pac here. Either that or he just doesn't care enough to put in the effort. Oh, and there's a drop kick. And Malik Brown is in full control of V-Pac here. Oh, neck breaker! Malik Brown now, saying V-Pac off the ropes. Oh, look at that, V-Pac with a quick counter into a kick. Jumping karate kick from V-Pac right there. And now look at this. Oh, Malik Brown. The second V-Pac starts to get any offense, Malik Brown counters him. Oh, with the shin breaker into the dragon screw again, and Malik Brown is bringing the fight to V-Pac here. Same V-Pac into the corner. Malik Brown now. Oh God, oh God. Lawn dart! And let's not forget, that's a move Tommy Ventura uses as well. So that may be a little spit in the face to V-Pac there. And Malik Brown knows he's in control. Oh! Malik going for the cover. No, V-Pac kicks out. Come on, V-Pac, you can do better than that. Only this, the cravat kicks. I'm sorry, the kawada kicks. Wait, look at this, V-Pac. Jawbreaker reversal. Again with the kick, and V-Pac. I think he's gonna try and mount a comeback here with a quick forearm. And there's another one. Here comes V-Pac. Pillion kick. Malik Brown for the first, one of the only times in this match, actually gets dropped by V-Pac. And V-Pac, look at this. I think it's time to form. Blazing sword. No, Malik Brown moved out of the way. And Malik Brown, I think he's had enough. He's looking for it. Jaguar knee. No, Malik Brown moved out of the way. Look at this. Hurricane Rana. V-Pac starting to fight back now. V-Pac getting this from, oh! He looked for the Hadouken, but Malik Brown, oh, look at that. Did you hear that? Malik Brown just said, really? And then smacked him right in the face. Malik Brown almost embarrassing V-Pac now. And I think Malik Brown is finally ready to get serious. Oh, God, oh, God, oh, God. Oh! Another lawn dart. Well, V-Pac, you wanted to fight Malik Brown. Welcome to the violence party. Malik Brown nailing the violence party on V-Pac here. And I think Malik Brown is looking to end this. Looking for it one more time. Jaguar knee! No! V-Pac moved out of the way! Oh, wait a minute! Wait a minute! V-Pacinator! He hit it! Oh my god! Uh-oh! Turns around and gets a Jaguar knee right to the face. I think he was busted open in the process. Going for the cover, referee Green Shoes, two. And that's it. Tommy Ventura just screwed over V-Pac. God Almighty in heaven. Well, we got the officials checking on V-Pac right now. They're trying to close his wound up. See Tommy Ventura on the top of the stage chuckling it up. Like he just won the Super Bowl.
The trainer escaped across the street. Jesus stripped bare. And made the spirit.
Well, Malik Brown with another impressive win. V-Pac put up a good fight there in the end, but you gotta wonder, if Tommy Ventura hadn't interfered, what would have happened? Wait a minute, Malik Brown going for a microphone now. I think he's got something to say.
Party. Just one big party, because this is what it's all about. See, now, not only am I the CZW Pride Champion, now I can add another belt to my long list of accomplishments. I am now the TGPW Euro American Champion, and trust me when I tell you this, just like many other belts that I've held before, this will be the belt that turns men into legends and legends into immortals. Because in my hands, this title is the title. In my hands, this is power. This is a tactical nuke ready to drop on the unsuspecting. Because I am not just here. My career, I am not here to just win. I am here to break the heart of gods, to crush false idols, and to silence false prophecies. I don't just hand out destiny. I make destiny. And like so many others, I am not here to just be complacent. I'm not here because of a name. I'm here because of determination, drive, and just the sheer balls to say F you. I don't care who is going for this title. You will fall like everybody else. You could be as the highest steel, you'll fall. You could be a CJ Hawkins, you'll fall. Hell, you could be a Matt Pharaoh, you'll fall. Because it takes more than just cheap pot shots to beat me. It'll take a lot more. to beat me. And you can say that. You can speak it to the rooftops, to the mountaintops, because I will stand in the mountain as your king, as your god, and as your champion, and I will be victorious.
Well, Malik Brown definitely making a statement here tonight that he is here to stay as your American champion. Whoa, wait a minute. Is that? See, it's steel! He's got steel! They just hit Malik Brown with steel! Bringing it to Malik Brown. Oh, pile driver. Good God in heaven. Zaya Steele. Coming right back in, into the commentary booth. Hey, V-Pac, how are you? Well, V-Pac needs a second to collect his thoughts, folks. Nonetheless, we're going to go ahead and get started with our next match as we got some tag team action. Soul Reaper set for action team with Jason Collins tonight against the tag team champions Mike and Stray. We'll be teaming with Soul Reaper. I'm sorry, the Broken Soul Reaper. During Royal Rumble Week. Well, it looks like V-Pac's finally ready to come back now. How you feeling, man?
How do you think I feel? I just had a super cool the damn cut suck.
Oof. That was nasty. I get you. Go ahead, V-Pac.
You saw what happened.
I did. Did you see what happened after?
Yeah. I came this close to knocking off Malik Brown.
Well, you can take solace in the fact that Zayas Steel went in and, well, pretty much got, he had your back afterwards.
Yeah, I thank him for it.
Malik Brown just got a healthy hope and of Reaper's elbow.
Hold on a second. One of the aides at ringside just gave me an ibuprofen.
Well, nonetheless, Jason Collins said to be teaming with Soul Reaper tonight. And this is certainly going to be an interesting tag team bout, to say the least.
And then, of course, that thieving bastard had to stick his nose where it didn't belong.
And nonetheless,
what the hell? Why is Broken Soul Reaper telling what Johnny Mike and Stray Meeks story?
Because Johnny Mike and Stray Meeks will be in, will be with Soul Reaper in the six-man tag team match to decide the fate of who gets the name Soul Reaper. Either the Broken Imposter or the definitive Soul Reaper himself. It'll be the Broken Reaper, Johnny Mike and Stray Meeks, versus the original Soul Reaper, Jason Collins, and yet an unknown third person.
Oh, I gotta respect Jason Collins for sticking with the original Soul Reaper. Even though they're down a man here tonight.
Indeed, but it's good, knowing these two, it's going to be a tough battle, especially considering how dominant the tag team champions have been. Running over every tag team TPGW has to offer. I literally believe there is no one left that can beat them. And nonetheless, here we go with this contest.
Original Soul Reaper just going right up the straight knee and hitting him right in the face. Jesus.
Well, just look at it this way, V-Pac. During Royal Rumble week, we're still going to get a shot at Tommy Ventura nonetheless.
Oh, I can't wait to get my hands on that thieving bastard. Especially after what happened just moments ago.
Well, V-Pac, I almost hate to say it, but looking at you right now, I have to say, we got a bleeder!
Oh, God, don't tell me Super Glue came undone.
A little bit.
Ugh. Give me a second.
But nonetheless, Stray Meeks. Soul Reaper into the corner. Reaper with a reversal.
Here's is it any better?
Yes, it's better.
I said I wanted to get blood all over the place.
At least now whenever you call, we've got a bleeder. You'll have the whole new... You'll remember this night. Don't feel too bad, V-Pac. Malik Brown has gone up against some of the best and come out on top.
I swear he's got those knee pads loaded with something sharp in there. At least that's what it felt like.
Well, nonetheless, Johnny Mike in the ring now with Jason Collins hitting that big time leg lariat right there. Oh, and a huge knee right to the gut. Collins with the reversal there.
Yeah, Johnny Mike blocking the overhead belly-to-belly suplex attempt there from a man of 10,000 DDTs.
Is it 10,000 now? I didn't realize he had gained 9,000. Well, it wouldn't surprise me. Not quite
I
a deep.
I want to put it faster.
Johnny Mike. Looks like he's got some. Oh!
Well, let's change the call. I'm trying to fire out of the enemy quarter.
And Johnny Mike sending him right back in. This is tag team warfare, a specialty of the tag team champions. Hence why they're the tag team champions. Look at Collins, German suplex.
I don't see that out of the playbook of Collins very much.
Indeed, Collins trying to mix things up. I think they'll expect a DDT from him. And there's the tag to Soul Reaper. Johnny Mike in trouble. Ooh! Reaper with a tiger suplex.
Momentary eye contact with his broken counterpart.
Indeed, can you blame him? He's got to have eyes in the back of his head for this match.
It's hard to believe that this imposter has actually had the original's number so far in their both encounters.
Indeed, they're going to need one hell of a trump card. The original's going to need one hell of a trump card to actually put the broken one away.
Yeah, well, it's still the X Factor, that mystery third man. And we don't know who Soul Reaper and Jason Collins got to be on their team.
Supposedly they don't have anybody on their team yet. It's just the two of them so far. No one wants to go against, I guess you could say no one wants to try and take on the dominant tag team champions. So the broken one's kind of got quite an advantage right now.
Huge knife edge chop there by the original Soul Reaper to the cover.
Indeed, that knife edge chop about as sharp as that Jaguar knee you took earlier. Scientists with the moves they come up with.
Look at this though.
Single leg.
Like Boston Crab there by Soul Reaper. Where he meets in a lot of trouble here.
But look at that, he just powers right out.
Of course, yeah, straight meets. He's one big guy.
He's a big guy with a lot of agility. And what do you know, the first DDT of the match didn't come from Collins.
Now, the little Soul Reaper again in the tag champ's corner. Big clothesline there.
Indeed. V-Pac, you gotta admit, this is smart tag team work here.
It most certainly is.
Oh, God.
Oh, jackknife powerbomb on the way here. No! And he got it. There's Rogan Reaper, and Rogan Reaper's loving every second of this.
He really is.
Original Soul Reaper. In a lot of trouble. Well, the Soul Reaper hits a Gary right to the face there. By Johnny Mike.
Hey! spine. And there's nowhere I'd rather be than in the stir of the echoes under the ages. Stories of greatness. And I'll never let go till I'm in the pages. Yeah, I'm gonna chase it. I wanna be right there with the heart of a warrior. Right there with the pride and glory. Time's come now. I wanna be right there in the mind of the fearless. Right there when the end is nearing. Time's come now. Bring me the fire. Bring me the war. Give me the ones I came for. Bring me the fire. Bring me the war. Give me the ones I came for.
What have I become? Well, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next on Fury, it's main event time. As Daniel Stone targets another New Guard member. Only this time the New Guard's backing him up. But Daniel Stone's got some backup of his own, V-Pac, and the number one contender for the Cruiserweight Championship, Frost.
Yeah, this is definitely going to be, Daniel Stone's definitely going to have his work cut out for him.
And that's next on TPGW Fury. Main event time, right now! Here tonight with the world champion and cruiserweight champion accompanying him down to ringside. Sergeant Ghost isn't here tonight because he's preparing for a one-on-one battle with Daniel Stone on Showdown.
That's where he is. There you see 3/4 of the New Guard. Whereas Tony Gordon's going to have his hands full on Royal Rumble week now, isn't he?
That's right. It'll be a triple threat match with the UCWL champion Green Arrow and the ZCW champion Kenny Omega. But tonight, they have to worry about the All-American Outlaw. There you see Frost following behind. I gotta think that Frost is mostly out here to target Patrick Wolf.
Oh yeah, they obviously, I don't think these two are buddies at all. I just think they have a common enemy they wanna take out. Of course, it reminds me of the old phrase, the enemy of my enemy is my friend.
And right now the New Guard is public enemy number one. Especially when it comes to the All-American Outlaw. Will Daniel Stone claim another victim in the New Guard? Or will the New Guard succeed in putting Daniel Stone away? We're about to find out right now, V-Pac. It certainly is going to be an interesting battle. After all, let's not forget that back in the old days of TPWF, it was Stone and Blaze back in their rookie years when they were originally supposed to compete one-on-one for the Kickstart Championship, basically our version of NXT.
I see.
So this is a battle that has been... That is 3 years in the making.
And of course, a lot has changed in that 3 years. Of course, Daniel Stone won the TPGW World Title.
Taylor Blaze won the WFS World Title.
Taylor Blaze would join Tony Gordon in this New Guard faction, and Tony Gordon would show his true colors by turning his back on Daniel Stone.
Indeed, and Daniel Stone making an example of Taylor Blaze so far. Look at this! You had to know this was coming, V-Pac. This is exactly what he did to Patrick Wolf last week inside the steel cage.
Yeah, Patrick Wolf is not looking at ringside right now. Like, he's squeamish to even think about it.
And Frost is loving every single bit of violence that he's seen. And look at this, Tony Gordon.
Wait, come on. Tony Gordon on the ring apron. There's no business for him being there.
Ow! And a backbreaker to Stone.
Oh, man, I think the ibuprofen is finally starting to kick in.
That's good to know. And look at this. Oh! Taylor Blaze shot to the back. Daniel Stone, reversal. And look at this. Taylor Blaze, a reversal of his own. He doesn't want to get Germaned anymore.
Oh, I wouldn't blame him. Wait a minute. What the hell?
Did Tony Gordon just put a chair in there?
He did. And I think the referee's just starting to realize it. Oh, come on.
Uh-oh. Stone not having owned any of it. And uh-oh. Yeah. German.
One German. There's a dragon suplex.
And I think we're going to get the full Chimera with the straight jacket. German. With the bridge. Look at this.
Referee out of position. Two and no.
And look at Tony Gordon again.
Tony Gordon now distracting Daniel Stone, allowing Taylor Blaze to get to his feet.
But Stone not having any of it. Oh! Reverse DDT right there from Daniel Stone.
Stone now back elbow to the...
Whoa! Capital punishment!
Capital punishment out of nowhere. Is this it?
Two. Oh, come on!
Ah, Tony Gordon, what the hell?
Whoa! Here comes Frost and Patrick Wolf.
Frost going after the Cruiserweight Champion.
Frost, I think, is seeing enough. Patrick Wolf's playing interference. And is this what we're going to see during Royal Rumble Week? Look at this brawl going on right now between Wolf and Frost.
It is possible, let's see me.
You see.
Right now, look at this. Frost team battling Patrick Wolf up the entrance ramp. Those two are going to be for the Cruiserweight title at Royal Rumble Week.
Look at Frost go.
Frost just pummeling away on the Cruiserweight Champion right now.
Oh!
And down goes Patrick Wolf.
Patrick Wolf, I've never seen him dominate like this before, except for Stone, of course. There's a neck breakout.
I don't care how beat up I am, I'm not doing it.
Patrick Wolf start to fight back.
Yeah, but you gotta wonder if he's damaging Frost in any way, shape, or form with all that armor on him.
And wait, where's Patrick Wolf going?
Patrick Wolf and Frost, it looks like they're going back.
Oh!
Oh, wait a minute.
Well, listen, and I think this match has been thrown out.
Indeed, this match is going to end on disqualification. Daniel Stone's the winner, but Tony Gordon's going to make sure that he doesn't attack any more of the new guard. You got to think that Gordon's been foaming at the mouth for this opportunity. And now Daniel Stone! And look at this, V-Pac. These two are just going at it right now.
Oh, they most certainly are. Oh, it was just, oh, pump handle slam there from the world champion.
And Daniel Stone is in a world of trouble, V-Pac.
He most certainly is.
No, oh, in the boot.
Off big boot.
Wait a minute! CJ Hawkins! Coming to the aid of Daniel Stone! Wait a minute!
What the hell?
It's Rex!
CJ Hawkins was coming to the aid of Daniel Stone, only to get intercepted by Rex Titus. Well, what the hell is this about?
Rex attacked Mal Rian earlier in the night, don't forget. Rex wants to...
what the hell?
Rex wants
what
to
the hell is this? Why is he helping the new guard?
He's not helping the new guard. He's helping himself win the Royal Rumble. He's going to try and take out each one of them individually. First Mal Rian and now CJ Hawkins. Ow! Ow!
Now Hawkins chucked over the guardrail. And Rex Titus in pursuit. And a super soldier taking it to CJ Hawkins.
Rex Titus believes he's some sort of new knight. Wait, Stone! Oh, Rex Tyson!
German suplex onto Tony Gordon.
And Daniel Stone now! Oh!
Two!
Well, we can't see Rex Titus or CJ Hawkins anymore. But I can tell you that Daniel Stone is taking the fight to Tony Gordon.
Yeah, it looks like the rest of the new guard have abandoned him. I don't see Taylor Blaze anywhere in ringside anymore.
Yeah, I can see him. He's right over there. He's knocked out. I think that capital punishment took more out of him than we thought. And look at Stone!
Daniel Stone.
Giving Tony Gordon exactly what he deserves.
Daniel Stone just taking it to Tony Gordon right now.
Whoa! And now the ring. Wait a minute!
What the hell?
Dr. Dream!
What is Dr. Dream doing here?
He's attacking Stone!
But why?
They're in the Rumble! It's every man for himself, and Dr. Dream is trying to gain some momentum here by taking out Daniel Stone. Oh.
And now Dr. Dream.
Whoa, and now the ring goes Daniel Stone. And look at
Daniel
this.
Stone, and I love this. Dr. Dream doing push-ups in the middle of the friggin' ring like he's some kind of... Wait, what the...
Raven Dark! It's Raven Dark, V-Pac! Wow!
Yeah, look at this. Raven Dark now making Dr. Dream pay for sticking his nose where it didn't belong.
and down goes Dr. Dream. Raven Dark is taking the fight to the dock here.
He most certainly is.
Whoa! And now the ring goes.
Dr. Dream.
Goodbye. And Raven Dark stands tall. Oh!
Now what?
It's George Alpine!
Alpine?
Indeed, Alpine waiting in the wings. Oh! Raven Dark was celebrating. Oh no! He tried to get the drop on the Dark One! Alpine, he's going up top! Whoa! This is insanity. Raven Dark is plowing through everyone. First Dr. Dream and now George Alpine. Oh, goodbye, Alpine. Wait,
Rex Tyus is back.
We knew this was coming. Raven Dark returned when Rex Tyus was trying to do some damage. And now Rex Tyus is going to try and take out the Dark One. Oh, God. Ooh!
Jesus. And these two are picking up right where they left off.
Rex Tyus is just relentless right now.
He most certainly is.
What a war being waged right now between Rex Tyus and Raven Dark. Or should I say just Rex Tyus? Because right now Raven Dark is being decimated by the Super Soldier.
Now what's Tyus gonna do?
Oh God. Oh, snake eyes! And Rex is gonna do everything in his power to destroy Raven Dark, and there you see. Obviously something happened with CJ Hawkins and Rex is not 100%.
And now, Tyus, what's this?
F5! And Raven Dark is out. And now he's out of the ring. Rex Tyus, ever so dominant. Oh my God!
Holy water! Holy water! Oh God.
Duncan! Oh God! Now Duncan's here and he's attacking Rex! Rex Tyus wanted to prove he was dominant, but he forgot about one person.
And that was, of course, Duncan for Bill. Or as I should now christen him, the Ashura-powered Duncan Vermeil.
Ashura's Nightmare taking it to the self-proclaimed American Nightmare. Only one of them is a real Nightmare, and I think we're about to find out who. Oh, God! Rex hanging on. He doesn't want to be taken out like everyone else. And Duncan bringing him back in. He's not done with him yet.
Duncan Vermeil now. What the hell is he looking for?
Oh God, he's got a chair, V-Pac.
And now...
Oh!
Daniel Stone.
Or Duncan Vermeil.
Big clothesline.
Big clothesline from Duncan. Oh God, Rex is in trouble. Rex is in trouble. Duncan, oh! Good God in heaven. And we still don't know who the mystery 10th man in the Rumble match is supposed to be.
That's right. And look at this. Oh!
Duncan has just destroyed Rex Titus. Again. And out of the ring goes Rex. The Nightmare is the only one left standing tall, V-Pac. Oh my God!
Now what?
There is no freaking way he's back so soon.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh God, it's him!
Cash! Kevin Cash! Oh my God, V-Pac, I just got through in the back. Cash is the 10th man!
Alright!
And Cash looking for a little bit of payback! Woohoo! Kevin Cash! Oh! Flying through the air and taking out the Nightmare! He's already sent him over the top rope, and now he's just looking to destroy Duncan! For what he did.
Just look at him go to work on Duncan.
The Nightmare is bamboozled. He doesn't know what to do. And Kevin Cash is all sorts of fired up right now.
Oh yeah, he most certainly is. After what Duncan Vermeil did him, what was it, Crossroads?
During Elimination Chamber week two. Cash is back with a vengeance. He's taking the fight to the Nightmare.
He almost certainly is.
Oh, wait a minute, Duncan, reversal. Catch! Look at this, Kevin Cash looks like he's perfectly fine. Where is this coming from, V-Pac?
I have absolutely no idea.
And Cash, he's looking for the Falcon Arrow, and there it is! He done did the deal! Now, how about a little bit of suicidal plunge for you? Whoa! Trying to take out the Nightmare and Cash. Oh!
Sunset Flip Powerbomb. And I think finally this whole Rumble thing is over with.
And the only man standing tall is Kevin Cash. What a night!
Certainly has been.